Welcome already. We've only been here like 5 minutes. And the women are beautiful and they're just, it's just amazing. I am speechless and that is not me.
Around 70 people live in Makoko. And during her time in the village, Linda will be expected to live and work as a Bobongo woman. Mama Tito is a widow in her 50s, and Linda will share her one-room hut.
My bed. Me? Me and you? Or me? Two? Here? Right, oh, lovely, lovely, very nice. Oh. Let's have a go. Oh, right, okay. Oh, nice. I won't be scared on my own then. Thank you. I had to say to Madame Tito that the bed was fine, but to be honest, I just have to see how it goes. I just don't really know if I'm going to turn over and give it a cuddle or, you know, thinking she's somebody else or wake up and go, oh my God, who's this next to me?
Mama Tito is a mother of 8. Her daughter, Nyange, lives in the hut next door with her husband, Bisiello, and their 5 children. The main meal of the day is in the evening, when the whole family eats together.
Ow!
As the new tribal wife, Linda's expected to help prepare dinner.
Hot, hot! Ow! Hot, hot!
The main staple is a root vegetable called manioc. It's boiled for hours until it's soft enough to eat.
To be honest, it doesn't taste that bad. It's just, it's not like a horrible taste. It's just very, very bland. I could do like a few spices on it.
Mama Tito, will we be having this for breakfast in the morning? Okay, that's fine. That's good.
Mama Tito's husband was the chief of Makoko. Since he died 7 years ago, she has been head of the family. And with her new visitor, she's quick to establish who's in charge.
Chair. I'm a slave now. Oh my God, it didn't take here long, did it? Me? Oh, she likes the left side. It's the right side. Pass me my chair, pass me my lamp. Do you think she is? I'm the guest.
Ah!
Don't know how to open it. Help!
Oh my God.
Hey! Up here.
Mama Tito's neighbours size up the new tribal wife.
Linda konjika tidi gadi. Linda anye peta tinye peke. Tilinda na bivido, ajanza tati janzaka.
Tini samba 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 ni bisena Linda mpoka ira tina hii. Linda tiba chiyango tiba mapokuwa. Tina mambe jamazo.
Titi Linda. Mugatonazo. Eke dio tie vidwe yeso. Tia godi bua. Linda eke dio. Tiba bakia di vanika Linda mene.
As the day draws to a close, it's Linda's first night in bed with Mama Tito.
I just hope when I go to bed I'll sleep, because that's the only thing I'm uncomfortable with.
I'm trying to sleep, but I just can't. I'm speaking quietly because Madame Tito is asleep. And she's snoring.
It's 6 in the morning, and it's been a long night.
Oh, I had a terrible sleep.
Babonga women take pride in their homes, and housework starts early here.
Ma.
No one's ever told me as soon as I got up in the morning to clean up. What I do when I get up is I like to go up an hour before I'm doing anything so I can sit down and have a cup of coffee, watch a bit of television and relax. No chance here, is there?
Nature calls, and Mama Tito shows Linda the toilet.
I actually wee here. You know, anyone can come round and see you having a wee. I'm missing my privacy big time. Thank you. These people here, they've got nothing. They wear the same clothes day in, day out. They go to sleep in the clothes, they wake up and they wear them again. They've just got nothing, but they just get on with it. And they're such nice people. Come on, chick. Come on, then. Hurry up. Come on.
During the dry season, the whole village, men, women and children, go to work in the forest every day. The men clear large areas and then burn the land to prepare it for crops. Children are also expected to pull their weight. They have an intimate knowledge of the forest and set traps to catch rodents to eat.
It's getting humid today. There's no sun out. I think it's only about like 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock in the morning. And I'm feeling a bit hot already.
Each family chooses a plot to cultivate, which the women plant and maintain. Linda will help Mama Tita with hers.
Makes it look so easy. I think I'm getting on okay. You know, it's my first time. So they're showing me and telling me how to do it.
Luana da, Okume jo okume foi. Oje ki amani arefe. Do kwa singima nganyungewo. Iyo. Imo.
Mama Tito takes Linda to collect resin to make torches.
Right. Oh, there you go. It's like a piece of snot. The forest to them is their supermarket, basically. They come here, they eat, they get the food, they get the light, they get the firewood, they bathe. It's absolutely astounding what they do and, you know, how they live off the forest. This is just like one aisle. I'm sure there's going to be loads of other places and other things that I'm going to discover.
After a busy morning, everyone sits down for lunch. It's a chance for Linda to meet some more of Mama Tito's family.
When I was growing up, I got myself into a lot of trouble. Petty things like shoplifting and taking days off school when I shouldn't. So I was sort of a rebellious child. I think I was trying to get attention from my mum. She wasn't there.
In this community, family ties are important.
Being here and seeing Mama Tito with her family, they all seem to be really, really close. Whereas when I was growing up, our family wasn't like that. You know, we always seemed to be sort of looking out for ourselves and not helping each other. You know, I left home when I was 17. I got pregnant when I was 17. I made my way in the world on my own. The way family life works here, they're just so connected. You know, and it's a nice thing.
Back in the village, something catches Linda's attention.
Oh God, there's some fella talking to the trees. No, there really is some fella talking to the trees over there. I'm really beginning to get... I am really beginning to get spooked out. God, how am I going to get over this? There's a strange feeling in the village. I've just got a feeling that something is gonna happen.
It's the middle of the night, and Linda's fast asleep. She's woken by noises in the village.
It's like 3 o'clock in the morning. I was in bed asleep. I'm just sitting here and watching all this going on. It's just unreal. It's just, I think I'm in a dream. It's unreal. But the village has just come alive.
This is the Bwenji ceremony. It's held every year at the start of the dry season to pray for a plentiful harvest, and always takes place under cover of night. The village men chant and drum to call the spirits of their ancestors from the forest.
You know, it's a whole new atmosphere. I feel like quite excited to be part of it.
The hallucinogenic iboga plant plays a central part in many Babongo ceremonies, especially male initiation rites, where it's taken to achieve spiritual enlightenment. The fire bearers, or Ngunga, are the highest male initiates in the village and are believed to have the power to commune directly with the spirits. At 5 in the morning, Linda goes to bed exhausted. But the ceremony continues until dawn.
I'm just getting to bed. I don't know that I can sleep there because like I'm still high, I'm still quite high after it. It's all so very spiritual. We don't really see it, no one talks about it. But this village believes in those spirits in the trees. In the forest. They really, really believe in the spirits, all the ancestors, everything. I thought it was like a sleepy little village, you know, they go to work in the forest, they come home, they have the dinner, they sit by the fire, they go to bed. I just thought that was what it was about. But it's not, there's so much more to this village. It's all done in secret. I've hardly had any sleep. I think I've had about a couple of hours. It took me ages and ages to get off. Oh God, I'm shattered. I am absolutely shattered.
This morning, for something new for breakfast.
And I couldn't believe my eyes. Just standing, well, sitting by the bowl of manioc was this hand sticking out of the bucket, and I looked, I thought, shit, it's a fucking monkey.
Bushmeat is an important part of the Babongo diet. Men used to hunt with bows and arrows, but now have access to guns.
Back at home in England, don't go to the butchers for half a pound of monkey. You know, half a pound of beef, yeah. Well, what do you call monkey meat? And I just don't think... Maybe I'll try a little tiny bit. If it's cooked, if it's washed, if it's cleaned. You know, if it's got a bit of gravy with it. But there's no way I can't. I can't eat it. I can't. No, thank you. Just give me some manioc. I'm not eating that.
Having passed up the offer of monkey for breakfast, Linda sets off with Janet to dig up some manioc. It's an hour's walk to the plot in sweltering heat.
It's tough just getting up here.
Is that tough?
Look at that. Yeah? God, it's hard, this. You've got to dig really, really deep into the ground. It's really hard. Oh, hey! That's my tea. But you get sick of eating it. I've just been stung.
Harvesting manioc for the whole family is a daily chore for the women here.
It's physically hard. You know, all I'm used to is sitting behind a desk in an office. God, I've sweated more today than what I have done, but I do a week in the gym. I'm roasting. My knickers are sticking to me, I can feel them. Do you enjoy coming into the rainforest to do your work?
No, I don't like it.
Heavy.
It's been a good morning's work. Janet and Linda return to the village with baskets of plantain and manioc.
Mama Tito, got our food. You've got a smile. Hey, oh, it's worth it just for that smile. I can't believe that they carry it like that. You know, there must be an easier way. They must be able to make wheels or something and have a little trolley or something. You know, have that on the back all day. Jesus, it's so hard. It's physically tough going out into the forest. I'm full of mosquito bites, you know, and I just feel rotten. My fingernails are rotten, my toenails are rotten. It's very, very tough, very tough. Toughest thing I've ever done in my life. This is how they end the day, basically. They just all sit around the fire. You know, and it's a nice thing. It's a nice thing that they do that. It's so peaceful. It's been quite a long day today. I'm going to try to get a good night's sleep tonight.
It's 6 in the morning, and Linda's had another restless night.
You want to brush up? Mm.
Okay. Okay.
All here. Down there. All here.
As usual, there's housework to be done. But today, it's not just the front of the house which needs to be cleaned. It's the family toilet at the back.
Oh, I'm not picking that up. They come round here to have a wee, and all of the shite is thrown round here. You know, you don't know. I'm just not picking it up. I'd refuse. That's just one thing I'm not going to do. I'm not going to pick other people's crap up where they've been pissing. It's just degrading. I'm not doing it. I'm not doing it. I'm tired, I've had a rough night's sleep, and the first thing she does is give me a brush. I don't mind helping her, I like to help her, but I'm really tired, and I think I'm going to have a bad day. I'm missing home. And it's hard to stay cheerful when you're feeling upset. Kind of full of bites and so itchy. I've tried to keep it together, but I think I'm just broke today.
You
moto to more.
I really don't want to upset you in my time here because you've been so kind to me and so genuine. I've never met a person who I can feel so comfortable with. I'm missing my husband and my family because...
Linda, listen,
I'm just...
Listen.
I'm just having a bad day. It's nothing to do with you. Nothing at all.
Mutema kizanjo kumutema angaza njana de ando tembe umbi adiga nani umbi adiga nani umbi adiga nani mzeka kana ko timu timu eve de
ndakate nani
umbi adi anya wetu ndi mutema ukiati sahu kwa kundi mbe wa chikamane te chikaga
I just had a moment as we would say back in England, but I'm fine. I have been thinking a lot about my family. I think I've spent more time with Mama Tito in these days that I've been here than what I have in a month with my mum. And I feel a bit sorry about that, you know. When I was growing up, I suppose, I just wanted attention all the time. I wanted it to be all about me. But, you know, there was bloody 10 kids and she had my mother had the hassle of clothing us and putting food on the table. So it wasn't all about me. I realised that, you know, you're the selfish cow, Lynn. You know, it can't be like that. It's not like that. Life is not all about you. Life is not all about me. I'm having a wash in this gorgeous river. There's nobody about. I'm semi-naked and it feels absolutely fine. It's absolutely total freedom. The water's nice and cool, you know, it's just like my own big bath. You know, in the rainforest in Africa. Can't believe it. Beats Liverpool anytime.
Halfway through Linda's stay.
Thank you.
I had a really good sleep last night. It really feels good getting up so early. You know, the mist is just coming off the forest, the trees, and it looks and it just smells so fresh and it makes you feel really good and really fresh.
There's weeding to be done at the family plot. Linda heads off with Mama Tito, her daughter Nyange, and her grandchildren.
Oh, waza.
Look at you, Nan. That's what hard work is all about. When you're about that big, you'll be doing that. Watch and learn. Right, okay. Oh. Oh.
Mama Tito, get that for me. Go on.
Didn't I know I'm a chicken?
Hard. Watch this one, chop. Well done. Mama Tito, she's a great lady. She really is a great lady. She's got a heart of gold. And I'm glad that I'm a friend. I've got a lot of respect for the lady. You know, I really have got a lot of respect for the lady. She works bloody well hard. It's made me realise I don't know how lucky I am. I am so lucky. She just stuck it on my back and she carried the baby. Oh!
Aba kambe na na kambe linda ndi na dipiza mbetisinga bena kinyango na bena ndi timbeki aka undi yango na zekase kana nane na nyungu yango titi nyungu akia kumbana kedi bien.
Mama Tito sends Linda off to do the dishes with Nyange. There's something playing on Linda's mind.
I've just got my period yesterday. Are there things I shouldn't do? To be honest, I'm not really a spiritual or a religious person, but being here, it's made me think about their God. I find it quite intriguing, actually.
And while there's nobody else around, Linda wants to find out a little more about how relationships work here.
I don't see you hug or kiss your husband. Don't you do that? Oh, it's okay. Sisters. Do you love him very much?
Hey! Hey,
Yankee, I love my husband because he buys me clothes and he buys me makeup and he brings me things. So we're the same. It made me laugh because I'm like that with Gary. I mean, I fancy him and I love him, but he does bring me things. He provides. He's like, he spoils me rotten. When I think about it, I think I'm just taking the piss out of him, and I shouldn't be. I should respect him more, and I will. I will respect him more. Maybe for a few weeks.
Back in the village, Linda starts preparing the evening meal. She's forgotten she shouldn't prepare food during her period. Linda isn't allowed to help with meals for the rest of the week.
You know, I do like to help. But because, you know, I've got my period in the jungle, I can't. They won't let me.
Instead, Mama Tito has a little treat for her.
Ow! Be gentle. You know what? This is so relaxing. She hurts a bit.
She pulls her very tight, but it's so relaxing, someone doing your hair. I feel like a princess.
Linda's not the only one getting special attention. Mama Tito's neighbours have come to join in.
Going on holiday this year, love? Going anywhere nice? Or are you going out tonight? Getting your hair done? What are you wearing? Prada? Gucci? This is what I do every morning. I go and say hello to my fellow villagers.
Temuhia!
You know, I couldn't see myself going down my road every morning, knocking at my neighbour's house and saying, oh, hello, good morning. They'll think I was mad. It's tradition here, you know, this is what they do. It's nice because, you know, it just puts a smile on everybody's face.
Temuhia!
Linda's going fishing with Janet. The women go every week, and in the dry season when water levels are low, the river is an important source of food. On a good day, they can catch dozens. First, they need to catch the bait, jungle crickets.
The fish food.
That's a big one.
Wow.
She's got a good eye, give her that. Whey! I'd love to catch a fish. I'd really, really love to catch a fish. I never thought that I would actually be saying that I don't care, I've got no makeup on, I don't care where I am, I've had my knickers on for 2 days, but I just don't care. Normally at home I'll be like showering morning, night, you know, making sure my hair's nice, but here it's they don't care, they just don't worry about how they look and how they dress, and I'm sort of fitting in, you know, I feel like one of them now. It's great, I just don't care. I just don't think it's going to happen. They're just not, they're not biting at all, if that's the right word to use. For me, they're professional, they're not biting. An angular, is that what they're called? Worried about Mam and Tito and the face she'll have on if I don't bring no food down for her. So I'll stay here until I catch a fish, even though it's just one.
After several hours, Janet finally gets lucky.
Let me have a look! Oh! Huh? Oh, some nice fish for tea. Oh, well done, Janet! Oh, quite a big one, that. Oh, it's still breathing. Oh, look! Janet! It's still alive. Oh. Oh. Not alive now, is it?
Baby, we're pinned every day. Baby, we're on book. I got a job. Then my child will not pin. Then I got a job. I'm going to go.
Linda's delighted with their success and can't wait to show Mama Tito the catch of the day.
That was good. I was very good. I liked it. Yankee.
Mama Tito's got help from everyone in the village. Everyone rallies round. It's all one big happy family. My mother didn't have no one. The more I think about it now, my mum didn't have my father's support. She was sort of left to do it on her own. It must have been really, really stressful.
It feels good to bring home the food. It's worth it just to see that cheesy smile. See? Gracias. Okay.
Anybody fall?
Oh, full!
Manguti, oh, manguti.
Oh,
oh, oh. Mangutio.
Oh, my gutio. Hey.
It feels nice to have a bond with Mama Tito and her daughters. They seem to like me and I like them back. They've accepted me. They've accepted me as one of their own.
Oh, hold on a sec.
It does amaze me that I'm from millions of miles away, well, hundreds of miles away, and this woman who I've never, ever met in my life, she turns out to be sort of like a similar person to me. She likes to be the centre of attention, so do I.
Linda's time in Makoko is drawing to a close.
I feel like something's going on because this morning I can't do a thing wrong. Mama Tito, she's like, sit down, you know, don't brush up, and she's being extra nice to me.
Mama Tito and the other village women have decided to do something special to mark her departure.
Thank
you. Thank you so much.
Women are in charge of female initiation ceremonies. Men are barred from the preparations, and Linda is taken behind the back of the hut to get ready in secret. Niembe is the initiation ceremony all Babongo girls go through to become women. It can last up to a month. white clay covering Linda's body symbolizes the purity of youth. She's still a girl in the eyes of the tribe and must keep her head bowed. Drumming and chanting calls the forest spirits to the village and asks them to bless the new initiate. As the women retreat indoors, the most sacred part of the initiation proceeds in secret. After 8 hours, Linda is allowed to leave the hut.
It's a lot of spiritual stuff has happened. Mama Tito and the villagers have been speaking to the forest. I think they've asked the spirits in the forest to accept me. I know that much. And I did feel as if, you know, they have accepted me, otherwise they wouldn't have let me in there. You know, and I feel proud to sort of be sitting here now next to Mama Tito after all what's gone on.
As day breaks, Linda's taken to the river to complete her initiation.
It sort of felt like I was getting looked after, like I was a baby, you know, as if all the spiritual thing what happened last night was getting washed away. And like now I've just become this woman. You know, the child has been washed away. I just feel cleansed, I feel like, you know, clean all over, inside and out, it just feels good. It feels like it is a fresh start, and I'm sure it will be a fresh start because my mind's all clear for some reason, and I just feel as if I'm going to go home and I'm just going to change. Things are going to change. It's opened my eyes about what being rich is all about. Being rich isn't about having possessions. These people haven't got anything. And all they believe in is, you know, respect and love for each other. So I'm sure I can live with a little less than what I've already got. And I'm going to try my best.
It's Linda's last day in Makoko.
Mama Tito has been a lady who I've got the most respect for. And I have looked up to Mama Tito while she's, you know, while she's had me here. And I'd be so sad to see a little face when I go.
C'est comme ça. Même moi. C'est là. Mon petit pour moi là, même moi, c'est comme ça.
All that worry I had about looking back at my past and, you know, it must have been so bloody hard for my mum to bring us up. She had a lot going on in her life. And being here has made me realise, you know, it wasn't too bad after all. So all that baggage just completely, completely and utterly disappeared. And I've got a new respect for my mum. When I go home, I am gonna make more time to go and see my mother.
Kaun dongi ne na babo na jen dongi ne tindi mbembe mugato ni kate kenge mugato se kate na ko we gun dongi ne tongo no kote nani. Mbe mugeto okenya kiumbele ukunja keli hati amo na ngoni gaewe.
You have been an important person in my life, one of the most important people that I've ever come across, I've ever met, and I've learned a lot while I've been here. This is beyond anything I've ever done in my life. I feel like I can go home and just start totally fresh, like as if it's from day one. And these people have helped me do that. And I really, really miss them.
Six women are going to live with communities in some of the most remote places on Earth.
Wow.
Oh! Like many women today, juggling career, home and family, they feel that something is missing. By spending time in societies where female roles are very different, they hope to find answers that could change their lives. Linda Plover is travelling nearly 4,000 miles from her home in Liverpool to the African rainforest. She's going to live with the Babongo tribe in Gabon.
This is the most adventurous thing I've done. I know it's not going to be like I live back at home, because I've got all my comforts back at home. You know, I've got my makeup, my hair dryer, my hair straighteners. Oh my God, what am I going to do without my hair straighteners?
The Babongo have lived in these forests for thousands of years. Their survival depends on the food they find and grow here. The forest is sacred to them. They believe it's inhabited by ancestral spirits, unseen but ever present, with the power to cure and kill. Back home, 44-year-old Linda works as a receptionist. She has a 25-year-old daughter, Haley, and two grandchildren, Alex and Abigail.
Oh, look, he sparkled! Did you see it? Oh, my goodness gracious me!
Haley Bailey now lives nearby, so it's just Linda and her husband Gary at home.
I get up in the morning, I go to work, I come home, sit down, watch telly, have a glass of wine, and it's day in, day out, day in, day out. And sometimes I just sit there and think, there must be something. There must be something else.
Nearly every week, Linda buys new clothes or another pair of shoes.
I do spend a hell of a lot of money, and I know I do. It's just madness the way I spend money. It's crazy, and I don't need half the stuff. Half the stuff still got the labels on. I think the way I spend money on clothes and makeup is because I'm scared in case it's going to go. I don't want to go back to what it was like when I was a child.
Linda was one of 10 children and grew up on a council estate in Liverpool.
It was really rough. I remember sleeping in a double bed with two of my sisters, with sort of coats on the bed. I was just like sort of shoplifting, you know, only because I didn't have things. I used to go out and socks for school. You know, I used to go out and pinch them. I mean, okay, we had no money, but we didn't have what we should have had. I can't remember my mum giving me a cuddle and giving me a kiss and saying, I love you, you know? I can't remember that. And it hurts. Every woman needs a mum, you know, to talk to for advice, and I didn't have that. To this day, I can't get my head around it. I would love to tell my mum how I've felt growing up, how I've thought about my past. And just say, you know, I just want to get rid of this feeling, this bitterness.
Linda will spend almost a month with the Babongo. She's been travelling for 4 days to get to a small village 100 miles south of the equator, in southern Gabon, called Makoko.
Hopefully, they'll be just as nervous as I am, because they don't know what to expect. They're most probably a bit curious, and hopefully they're tidying up the house.
Linda is greeted with a traditional Babongo welcome. Mama Tito, one of the most respected elders in the village, has leapt at the chance to have an extra pair of hands and has invited Linda to stay with her.
Mama Tito, she is great. She's a little dance what she did with me. It was really, really nice. They just made me feel so welcome already. We've been here like 5 minutes. And the women are beautiful, and it's just amazing. I am speechless, and that is not me.
Around 70 people live in Makoko. And during her time in the village, Linda will be expected to live and work as a Babongo woman. Mama Tito is a widow in her 50s, and Linda will share her one-room hut.
My bed. Me? Me and you? Or me? Two? Here? Right, oh, lovely. Lovely. Very nice. Very nice. Oh. Let's have a go. Oh, right, okay. Oh, nice. I won't be scared on my own then. Thank you. I had to say to Madame Tito that the bed was fine, but to be honest, I just have to see how it goes. I just don't really know if I'm going to turn over and give her a cuddle or, you know, thinking she's somebody else or wake up and go, oh my God, who's this next to me?
Mama Tito is a mother of eight. Her daughter, Nyange, lives in the hut next door with her husband, Bisiello, and their five children. The main meal of the day is in the evening, when the whole family eats together.
Ow!
As the new tribal wife, Linda's expected to help prepare dinner.
Hot, hot! Ow! Hot, hot!
The main staple is a root vegetable called manioc. It's boiled for hours until it's soft enough to eat.
To be honest, it doesn't taste that bad. It's just, it's not like a horrible taste. It's just very, very bland. I could do like a few spices on it. Mama Tito, will we be having this for breakfast in the morning? Okay, that's fine. That's good.
Mama Tito's husband was the chief of Makoko. Since he died 7 years ago, she has been head of the family. And with her new visitor, she's quick to establish who's in charge.
Chair. I'm a slave now. Oh my God, it didn't take here long, did it? Me? Oh, she likes the left side. It's the right side. Pass me my chair, pass me my lamp. Do you think she is? I'm the guest. Ah! Don't know how to open it. Help! Oh my God. Hey! Up here.
Mama Tito's neighbors size up the new tribal wife.
Linda konchita tidi gadi. Linda anye peta ti nye peke. Ti Linda na bi vido, a janza ta ti janzaka.
Ti ni samba 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 ni bise na Linda mpo kaira ti na I. Linda ti ba chi yango ti ba mapoko ba. Ti na mambe ya maso.
Titi Linda. Mugatona so. E ke dio ti e vidu e yeso. Ti ago di bua. Linda e ke dio. Ti ba ba ke adi vani ka Linda mene.
As the day draws to a close, it's Linda's first night in bed with Mama Tito.
I just hope when I go to bed, I'll sleep, because that's the only thing I'm uncomfortable with.
It's 6 in the morning, and it's been a long night.
Oh, I had a terrible sleep. Terrible sleep.
Babonga women take pride in their homes, and housework starts early here.
Ma.
No one's ever told me as soon as I got up in the morning to clean up. What I do when I get up is I like to go up an hour before I'm doing anything, so I can sit down and have a cup of coffee, watch a bit of television, and relax. No chance here, is there?
Nature calls, and Mama Tito shows Linda the toilet.